stage on the joint side.
But I mean, is there any possibility of a film?
The first issue of Hot Press appeared in May of this year. It's one of a range of youth publications, some from the underground, some alternatives to the national press, some simply aiming at capturing a youth market commercially. The people at Hot Press want to come to grips with the feelings, the aspirations, the questions of young people. As in all such ventures, there was a central idea. Music was the focus here, and Hot Press aimed to provide a voice for youth through serious attention to their music.
There has been a great need for a music paper in Ireland which deals with music on a serious level. The magazines that have existed in the past have been considered by musicians, for a start, and by presumably any thinking person, to be little more than a joke. But we are in fact attempting in Hot Press to do much more than purely cover the music scene. We figured that there had been, up to our existence, a very big gap in the overall publishing situation. The 18 to 30 year old age group was never specifically catered for in the magazine, and we feel that one, taking music as a basis, and two, then operating on the broad spectrum of interests of the 18 to 30 year old age group, that we can produce a really relevant magazine.
There's a tendency in newspaper publishing to use news agency stories and publicity photographs. Hot Press staff try, wherever possible, to get their own. La, 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 la. La, 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 la. Top name British rock group Status Quo were on a tour which included Dublin. As a matter of policy, Hot Press will print their own photos with a review of the performance. The staff at Hot Press are young, of an age with their readers, and for most, this is their entry into journalism. They share the interests of the readers too, and they want no part of the traditional media or of the established press.
Quite honestly, I don't have a lot of respect for journalistic standards generally. I think the degree of compromise and sheer laziness involved is on a lot of levels is. Well, borders on being unethical, in fact, in my opinion. We're out to produce a magazine which is honest. Above all, I think we've got to try to break away from the tie to commercial considerations, which in particularly in the magazine area dominates. We are also trying to break new ground on a journalistic stylistic level. There are developments which have taken place outside Ireland. Which are specifically related to music, which we feel we can incorporate. This is say in magazines like Rolling Stone, Enemy, rock magazines in America like Crawdaddy, Cream, a stylistic basis which has evolved from people like say Tom Wolfe, Hunter Thompson, has it's a very important development in my opinion journalistically.
The established media doesn't think it's good to have passion, to have deep commitment, to be angry, to use the normal language of everyday life with its four-letter words. The alternative press is revolting against that, and its language is full of commitment and passion and everyday language. It's the new journalism, and they use words which would be shocking in the regular established press.
And that we are bringing something which is very definitely new in the Irish context in here. We expect it to upset people. We expect it to in fact infuriate a lot of people. But at the same time, I mean, I feel that in the long term that we're contributing a lot on a journalistic level.
About style, there's an example here of the sort of thing that could quite easily put off people. There are really only two ways to approach Motorhead. One, you can do a neat sidestep and catch the slipstream as it whizzes by. Or two, you can climb on the saddle, rev it up, and follow Lemmy in his unceasing search for the elusive eighth screaming Dizbuster. This is very much jargon, in jargon. Do you think it fits? Do you think it sits well on the
Irish? Yeah, I do. I mean, I think it's very important to be humorous for starters. And I mean, above all, that's trying to be humorous. And it makes me laugh. I mean, I hope it gives people the same buzz as it gives me.
Yes, this whole subculture which Hot Press represents has built itself around the focus of music as a kind of language, as a set of symbols that give life, give meaning to the life of the people in this subculture. The expression has been used that this is the magic that sets the people free from the technological man, the marketing man, the cerebral man that these people are revolting against, that they're looking for a way of life that has got more heart, more soul in it than the life of the bourgeois society and this established press and broadcasting medium, the cinema.
Punk rock, described variously as avant-garde or the music of despair, is a prime interest at the moment to readers of Hot Press, second only to the music or the look, the gestures, as difficult to interpret as the music itself sometimes. Nonetheless, it is the language of the young, and both visually and in sound, it says for them what they think of life and of society. It rejects the present and the future, much in the way it feels rejected and ignored by the established media. A critic from Hot Press is present as the punk group Revolver performs at The Project in Dublin. The crowd is young, and as like as not, many of them are unemployed. They feel society has no place for them, looks down on them. They are alienated. Previous music heroes, like Van Morrison and Rory Gallagher, gained fame despite being dismissed by the Irish music press. It is at these young people that Hot Press is directed.
Hot Press is fortunate in that this time there is a new creative surge in the rock movement in the form of punk rock, which has brought about a revitalization because rock had gone off into in rather esoteric stream, drawing on Japanese music and Javanese music and avant-garde electronic music, and had become removed from the life of the young people in the streets, the young people unemployed who see no future in contemporary society and are taking to this punk rock as a kind of religion to make their life bearable and worth living.
Hello, Tom. How are you? Good. Do you like that job we did for you last time?
We started off with quite a strong financial situation. We're not worried about that, although it's you know, the day-to-day cash flow situation in a new business is a problem. I'm confident that we'll survive. What we could do with, quite honestly, is an increase in advertising revenue, which is a vital aspect of any publishing. We've achieved more or less all the support we can get from record companies. I mean, there are a few that we don't consider totally directly relevant to us, but most of the major record companies have committed themselves to regular advertising, and I mean, we're happy about that. What we do have to do is to make a break into the more general area of advertising.
The economic people will see an audience here of maybe up to eventually 250,000 potential readers who are neglected by the established media. Will see this as a group of consumers to whom to sell audio equipment and jeans and all the other paraphernalia that goes with this subculture, and gradually it would drag the group into the establishment. The bourgeois establishment always tries to absorb any group which deviates from its norms.